I welcome you to another day of God's blessing. It is my earnest prayer that the blessing of the Most High will overshadow our life in the mighty name of Jesus. We've been studying from the book of Exodus chapter 23, verse 25. We have looked from different angle. We have looked at that story from different angle. We want to look at it this time from the angle of the covenant of victory. Exodus 23 from verse 25. And ye shall serve the Lord your God, and he shall bless thy bread and thy water. And I will take sickness away from the midst of thee. There shall nothing cast their young nor be barren in thy land. The number of thy day I will fulfill. I will send my fear before thee, and I will destroy all the people to whom thou shalt come, and I will make all thy enemy turn their back unto thee. I stop there. God decided to put his children on the path whereby they will be the one who will put their enemies to flight. So when God says, I will send my fear before you, it is to tell us what really happened when those four leper men in 2 Kings chapter 7, you read about them from verse 3, when they decided to move, as they got to verse 6-7, the Bible says, as they moved towards the camp of the Assyrian, God caused those people to begin to hear noise, a fearful noise, and they began to say to each other, we better pack our load and begin to get out of this place. We can hear the noise of chariots. We can hear the noise of war coming in our direction. When a man is on the side of the Lord, the enemy of that individual becomes the enemy of the Lord. And because when God decides to move on behalf of a man against his enemy, you know, from several miles away, you know, the person will be terrified. They will begin to run without seeing what is pursuing them, because God has sent a fear before them. He said, I will make all your enemies to turn their back unto you. When enemy turn their back, which means they are running away from you. That is all it implies. Now this also is part of the package that we get in serving the Lord. As we give our service unto the Lord, the benefits that comes to us, the dividend of serving the Lord, is that you will never be defeated in life. A number of times, I have heard people who come around to say, somebody is terrorizing me. Now, when you are a child of God, you are a child of a lion. Because Jesus, our Lord, is called the Lion of the tribe of Judah. And nothing dares the cub of a lion. Because his father walked in dominion. When you are in a neighborhood and somebody is terrorizing and you have to run away from that individual, which means you don't know who you are. You don't really get your identity. When witches and wizards are in any community and you enter there, They have to relocate to somewhere else. Because the light of God inside of you must push them out and they must turn their back. In any way where the enemy might have assert themselves over your life, God is going to turn the table for you. And you begin to prevail over them. You begin to rule over them. In the mighty name of Jesus. If you believe it, let your amen be better. Amen. To have victory is to prevail over opposition. Is to beat your challengers. Is to defeat all other contenders. And to silence every confrontation. You are supposed to be unstoppable. You prevail over opposition. You beat all challengers. You defeat all contenders. And you silence every confrontation that will ever come your way. Inasmuch as you have given unto the Lord what he demanded, the part of the Lord is to give you victory in every aspect of your life. I remember the story of one of our sisters who had a boss in the place of work who was trying to be naughty. And as much as this lady was trying to, this man was just saying, okay, if you won't do what I want, what I'm asking for, you will not make progress in this office. Everything about your life will be at a standstill. And one day, the lion inside of this lady came up. She came to the office in the morning and picked the sand in that office and threw it up. So just as this sand scatter, it is written, as the shaft is driven before the wind, so shall the wicked be driven before me. You, this man who say I will not have peace, you are out of this place. 1 week after that man was sacked from that place because he was standing on the way of a child of God. I remember one other incident. A brother in our church, we were in Kaduna then, work in one of these company, and so the manager, the branch manager, was just hostile to him. You know, do everything to frustrate this man. This man will come to the church and say, I don't know why my manager doesn't like to see my face. Each time there is anything, this is what do you wear. So one day the pastor said, go and tell the man, if you don't be careful or stop troubling my life, you will lose your seat to me. And he said, how could I ever say that one? If I say that, I will lose my own job. But one day, he got 2 queries in 1 week. So he summoned courage to say, Oga, enough is enough. It's like there is something you are seeking for behind me. You won't find it. You will have to go somewhere else to go and look for it. And the man thought, what gave you this type of a boldness? What gave you this audacity? I will deal with you finally. I will see your end. And the man said to him back, you won't see my end, I will see your end. And that was the end of the matter. 2 weeks later, the man had been writing application that he wanted to go on leave. So they just sent a letter to him that he should, his leave had been approved to go on leave. So the manager they posted to come and relieve him said he will never, he would rather resign than to go to Kaduna. And so when One person, second person said they are not going. So they decided, okay, this person that is here, you act in the capacity before the man return. Now, for that 1 month that he acted, he has a profit that they never had in that branch since it was open. And so when they made the return, they thought, this must be a mistake, let's try it. So they extended the leave of the man who was on leave by one other month. Say, stay 1 month since we are owing you some other leave. So you can stay 1 month. The thing repeated itself. So while the man was on leave, they gave him a letter of transfer and they make a confirmation to the man who was acting on his behalf. So the day the man decided to come and carry some of the things he have in the place, he met the man he was persecuting, sitting. So when the man knew he was coming, so he put his two legs on the table so that he knows that he has taken the chair from him. So when the man came in, he said, I warned you, you did not hear. Hallelujah. We were in Bauchi and we were to build a church, the headquarter church. Now we had a land outside of where they put all the other churches. Our church seems to be the only church in the GRA. And there was one man beside us who was very influential. He came and said to us, this church will not stand here. Every other church is at Bayangeri, so you move your church to Bayangeri. And we didn't drag anything with him. But he was just trying everything. In less than 1 week, they serve us revocation of the C of O that was given unto us, that our C of O has been revoked. So we say, this thing is not a small thing. No. If this one man will now sack a church, that will be a disgrace. So we turned the thing around. Everything the man was trying to use. About 2 weeks after that, there was an auditing. The man was once the head of the Pilgrim Welfare Board. So they audited the account and they said something was missing. So they were dragging the thing. In the process, one of the man he has cheated just got an appointment in Abuja. He was a soldier. So the man remembered, one man messed me up in Bauchi. So he sent soldier to go to Bauchi to go and carry him. So they carried the man for about 3 months. He was there in Zakula. We were doing our work. So the people who revoked our paper, when they now discovered that, wait a minute, it's like something was wrong. One of them opened up and said, well, I'm not the one. No. It is so and so and so that said it. That was why it was done. You need to see this person and that person. But in the meantime, you can continue your work. We won't do as if we see what is happening, but these are the people. Before that man will come back, the church was standing. He came and looked at the church one day and he opened his mouth. I remember one of them, he came one day and he discovered his house, because, you know, was sold and we bought. So he came one day and he saw the car parked in front of the house. So he asked the person opposite, say, what's that? Those are the new owner. And the man put his. Now, when you are fighting, when the enemy is trying to fight you, they are fighting against God. And there is no one can battle with the Lord. Hallelujah. Who can battle with the Lord? Who can battle with the Lord? Who can battle with the Lord? I say nobody. Who can battle with the Lord? Who can battle with the Lord? Who can battle with the Lord? I say nobody. Every hand that is battling with you will wither off. In the mighty name of Jesus. In serving the Lord, one of the dividends you get is in victory. I discover that every name that God introduces himself with his people is a name that indicates victory. For example, in Genesis 22, in verse 14, Genesis 22, 14, when he revealed himself unto Abraham as Jehovah Jireh, the Lord, the provider, it is to give victory over lack. And so if there is in any way you lack anything, the God that we serve is Jehovah Jireh, the Lord who provides, the Lord our provider. And I believe God within that he will provide for you. He will provide for all your needs in the mighty name of Jesus. When he introduced himself in Exodus chapter 15 verse 26 as Jehovah Rapha, the Lord our healer, it is to give victory over every form of sickness and ailment. There are people who spend all their life, all their strength, all their money fighting one disease over the other. But there is a God whose name is Jehovah Rapha, the Lord that healed. Now when it is by your side, he will give you victory over any form of sickness. I'm saying to you this morning, no matter the sickness, no matter how long it has been there, Jehovah Rapha, come over your life and eliminate those sickness in the mighty name of Jesus. When he introduced himself in Exodus 17, 15, Exodus chapter 17, verse 15, as Jehovah Nissi, the Lord our victory. The Lord our victory. It is to say that there is no physical battle against your life that the power of the Almighty God cannot defeat. Any physical battle you are fighting, by the power of the Almighty, today the Most High God come to your rescue and give you victory over them in the mighty name of Jesus. I have the word of God for somebody here. There is a court case against you, and this case, every evidence on this matter seems to be against you, but I've been asked to tell you, you will be vindicated. The case will be decided to your favor in the mighty name of Jesus. When he introduces himself in as Jehovah Mekediski, is our sanctifier. He sanctify, and if keep all the sickness, whatever things, ailment, whatever things that is internally that wants to fight inside of you, he has the power to nullify them. Whatever it is that is giving trouble to you internally, the power of God will eliminate them in the mighty name of Jesus. Jehovah Shammah was how he introduces himself in Judges chapter 6 verse 24 unto Gideon, the Lord our peace. He gives peace in the midst of every trouble. There is the God who is the giver of peace. He will give you all-round peace in the mighty name of Jesus. Every trouble rivers flowing around your life, every trouble storm beating around your life, the Most High God gives you peace in the mighty name of Jesus. He speaks peace into your situation in the mighty name of Jesus. When he introduced himself to David in Psalm 23 verse 1 as Jehovah Roi, the Lord my shepherd, is the keeper away from all evil, the keeper away from all trouble. Whatever it is, every form of insecurity around your life, the keeper of the keeper of Israel, who neither slumber nor sleep, will come to your rescue and manifest himself in your life. In the mighty name of Jesus. I have a numerous testimony in this regard. When God is your shepherd, there is no place you cannot live. There is no place that is called a dangerous zone for you. You know, because he will always be there. His presence with you will keep evil away from you. I live very long in the north, walk very long in the north extensively. Kaduna, Abuja, Bauchi, Kano, and the rest of them. And a number of times, in many of the riots and whatever that happened in the north, it was there, you know, like they would say in Yoruba land, koro koro eye like this. You see them, and you survive them. Some of them, we were fighters together to defend territory. At the end of it, we come out in one piece, unhurt, uncaught, unarmed. Hallelujah. In the midst of all kinds of trouble, all kinds of assertion, God always prove himself. When is your shepherd? There is nowhere you can live, whether in the mountain or in the valley, because his presence will be there. He will guide over you. He will watch over you. I remember that a number of times we would travel. There was one day we were going for one of the conventions. I think it should be 1994. We were traveling from Kaduna to Redemption Camp. We were going for a convention. At the middle of the road, our vehicle broke down. In the middle of the night, I think we had two tire problems. So when you have two tire problems in the jungle, that is, you have gotten to where you will sleep that night. So we are there in the midst of that thing, and some of this armed robber came around. They drove and they stopped by. We could see them, we could hear their conversation, and they were talking to themselves. The other one said, go and meet them. They said, leave them. It's like they are church people. They said, go and meet them. They said, leave them. Let's leave them alone. Let's go our way. Let's leave these people. They were there arguing for about 5 minutes, and they walked away. They left us there. We were looking at them. Myself, my wife, two other person were together in the car. We were looking at them, and they, you know, after they argue, they carried their vehicle and they went away. They moved away. One particular day, myself, we were also on a mission like this, when this group of armed robbers entered into the filling station where we were. We were queuing for fuel, and they came. They just parked in front, and people were shouting, and so we just moved to go and tell them, who are you? Do you have two heads? That everybody is queuing, and by the time you move there and you see the kind of things they carry together, you just do a U-turn as if you weren't actually going to meet them. See? Their own, it was not. They displayed the gun at the back of the car. You know, put the thing, carry. And they said, well, we are not troubling anybody here. We just want the fuel. We are going towards the north, and we were going on that same road. So they were going in front. We were following them. Because we are going on assignment that is time bound. We got to a place where police look at us and say, look, the road is bad. The road is terribly bad. There are some people in front of us. We know we are on a mission for Jesus. And when the man could not dissuade us, he said, well, if you say you are church people, your God will go with you. They were clearing the road. We will get to some place. They will have wounded people. They were going in front. We were following them. When God is your shepherd, even the robbers will become your escort. I have experienced that once. As a young boy, I've just gone on a business something with my mother, and so I collect something. So I was coming when I fell into the hands of these people who crossed the road. So I just used boldness and I passed them by. They were calling and I refused to. I pretended as if I didn't hear them. So they rushed and they grabbed me. Don't you hear? Oh, you were talking to me. I didn't know. You didn't see us. I thought you people are having a meeting. I don't want to disturb your meeting. So where are you going? So and so place. Who are you? They look at me and look at me. And one of them said, this boy, there must be something with this person. The way he's just doing. Say, let's follow him to the house. They followed me to our house. And when they opened the door, they went back. It was that the following day, the security in our street were now saying, where do I get those people from? That they are armed robber. They were carrying guns. So the security saw them. They ran into hiding. But they followed me. As soon as we knocked the door and they opened the door for me and I enter, they went back. What am I saying? When the Lord is your shepherd, you will live in the midst of all danger unhurt. And I'm saying to somebody here today that to the glory of God, every danger will be averted on your behalf. No matter what evil that have been determined, as the Lord live and as his spirit live, the presence of the Most High will carry you through all evil in the mighty name of Jesus. I have seen a number of things that make me believe that when God is keeping a man, nothing can kill him. When God is a keeper of a man, nothing can kill him. During the June 12th Abiola episode, we were also in the north. We came for the convention when the ultimatum was. So, as we finished and we were going, all the people in the north were moving to the south, so we wanted to go. So I met my mother and said, we are going. Say, everybody seems to be running away from there. You want to go where? There is nothing that is pursuing us. We have been told that there is no problem. So there is no need running. The day we landed the house, that is the day our landlord was leaving the house. He was packing everything that he has, leaving the house. So when he saw us, he was surprised. What are you people doing here again? Say, we are returned back. Say, you people, you don't like your life, oh. Even me, I am going. He left the house. In the whole of that compound, we are the only one in the house that is in the compound. Every other person has disappeared, ran away for their life. The unfortunate thing is that most of them that ran away because they don't want to die, they die. The landlord never returned to the house. He died. Now, nothing happened where he was running, but he died where he ran to. And those of us who decided not to run, we were there. Under the mighty hands of the Lord. I am saying to somebody here today, the protection of God will remain sure over your life. The protection of God will remain solid over your life. Whatever it is that is pursuing other, that is making others to run helter-skelter, will not affect your life. In the mighty name of Jesus. The power of the Almighty God will keep you away from all evil. In the mighty name of Jesus. If you believe it, let your amen be better. When you read what the Bible says in Deuteronomy chapter 28 verse 7, he said, the Lord shall cause thy enemy that rise up against thee to be smitten before thy face. They shall come out against you in one way and flee before you. How many times? How many times? How many ways? In other words, they will launch an attack against you once, and the thing will be repeated against them. It will be returned back to them in seven ways. That is the reason why in the blessing of Abraham, he said, blessed is everyone who bless you. And cursed is anyone who curse you. When somebody says he doesn't like my face, I always tell them, in your own interest, you better do. Because if you like me, you are blessed. If you don't, you are in trouble. It is not me, it is God. Amen. The enemy themselves know that when you are on the side of the Lord, they can't do anything against you. Balaam, in Numbers 23, as you read from verse 22 to 23, Numbers 23, 22 to 23, he said, God brought them out of Egypt. He had, as it were, the strength of an unicorn. Surely, there is no enchantment against Jacob, neither is there any divination against Israel. According to this time, it shall be said of Jacob and of Israel, what has God wrought? No enchantment against Israel, no divination against Jacob. In other words, if anybody pick your name, carry it anywhere, to do anything against it, it will not work. In fact, if you yourself carry your own, you are a child of God, you now carry your hand to the astrologer, say, help me check my palm. They won't see anything there. Because the blood of Jesus has covered the hand, they can't read anything out of that hand. So if anybody carry your name into evil place, as they carry the name, the blood of Jesus can't cover the name. And so all they will be seeing is the blood of Jesus. Enemy want to stay somewhere and begin to call you. From where I came from, they have some very wicked way of killing people. Somebody will stay in the jungle and call the name of somebody and shoot gun. And the man they shoot at, in, you know, imaginary shooting, will die where he is. In my place, they call it Akbekpa. If somebody want to call your name and want to shoot, when they call the name, his own head will appear. His own head will appear. Yeah. In the mighty name of Jesus. Yeah. He said, yeah, let's break it with mortar. By the time he carried the mortar, it will land on his own head. Bah! So let's put fire on the head. The thing begins to pain his own head. Because your head is hid in Christ, in God. Your life is hid in Christ, in God. And for anyone to reach you, he must first kill God and bring out Christ, and then kill Christ and bring you out of Christ. Until then, you are secure. The wife of Haman was saying to the husband in Esther chapter 6 in verse 13. Esther chapter 6 in verse number 13. When Haman told the wife and his friend the humiliation that befell him in the palace, he has gone to the palace to go and take order to eliminate Mordecai. But by the time he arrived there, God has turned the thing around. The king could not sleep that day, and he was waiting to honor Mordecai. And the first person that entered was Haman. So in verse 13, he was telling them what happened. And Haman told Zeresh, his wife, and all his friends everything that has befallen him. Then said his wise men and Zeresh, his wife, unto him, if Mordecai be of the seed of the Jew, before whom thou hast begun to fall, thou shalt not prevail against him, but shalt surely fall before him. It was his own wife. They have been plotting the evil together. But when the woman saw the first step, he said, we better stop here. If that man is actually the seed of the Jew, A covenant child of Abraham, you can't win over him. He said, you have started falling. You will surely fall. Every enemy that rises against you, they will fall for your sake in the mighty name of Jesus. I said, they will fall for your sake in the mighty name of Jesus. Experience of Moses in Egypt. God has asked Moses to go to the land of Egypt, to talk to Pharaoh. If the man does not want to believe, drop your rod. So they dropped the rod, and the rod became snake. Pharaoh said, well, this is not a big deal. He called his magician and said, throw your rod. And it became a snake. But one snake swallowed another. The one of Moses swallowed their own to say, one pass one. In every way possible, God will show his supremacy. In the mighty name of Jesus. In your life and around you, God will show his supremacy. In the mighty name of Jesus. If you believe it, let your amen be better. In Psalm 110, in verse 1 and 2, Psalm 110, verse 1 and 2, he said, the Lord said unto my Lord, sit thou at my right hand, until I made thy enemy thy footstool. The Lord shall send the rod of thy strength out of Zion. Rule thou in the midst of your enemies. In the midst of your enemies, he said, begin to rule, continue to rule. As the Lord live and as his spirit live, in the midst of your enemy, you will rule. In the mighty name of Jesus. David said, thou anointed my head with oil, my cup run over. In the midst, in the presence of my enemies. In the presence of your enemy, you will continue to shine. And God will keep you secure. He will keep you protected. He will keep you defended. In the mighty name of Jesus. And in order to make your victory to be solid and complete, God give you the legacy of anointing to keep you away from the hands of the enemy. In Psalm 89, when you read from verse 20 to 24, Psalms 89, from verse 20 to 24, he said, I have found David my servant. With my holy oil have I anointed him, with whom my hand shall be established, my arm also shall strengthen him. The enemy shall not exert upon him, nor the son of wickedness afflict him. I will beat down his foe before his face, and plague them that hate him. He said, but my faithfulness and my mercy shall be with him, and in my name shall his horn be exalted. Hallelujah. The sons of the wicked shall not afflict him. But he said, I will beat down his foes before his face. When you belong to God, you belong to the company of victory. And in every life's endeavor, victory will be your portion. Victory will be your song. Victory will be everything that has to do with you. In the mighty name of Jesus. God, who is a keeper from all evil, from all danger, we continue to keep, we continue to protect, we continue to defend you. In the mighty name of Jesus. If you believe it, let your amen be better. 2011 now, when there was this, is it 2011? One of the election, we went to the police station to vote, myself and my wife. So we went for accreditation. Because the polling station was just about 5 houses away from our house. After the accreditation, we move. Now the way God worked the thing that day, the queue was long. And suddenly, one of the machine developed fault. And so the man was struggling with it when one of the supervisors came. Now the man who was supervising happened to be a Christian brother who knows us. So as he fixed the thing, he just sighted us in the midst of the crowd. So he decided to test the thing with us. So he just brought us out of the thing. He said, come, let's try this thing. So he did the thing for us. And then we left the place. We are just entering the house, sit down. And when we heard the sound, from that police station, bomb. By the time we returned there, pieces of, you know, we are looking for the pieces of people. The place, not up to 5 minutes. Just finished, walked away from the place and moved to our house. Just sat and said, okay, in the next 31 hours, we'll go back to do voting. Well, that was the end of balloting in that station for that election. Because the polling officer, people, but one way or the other, God removed us from the place. At the nick of time, he brought the man, and as he finished the thing, he called the man, yeah, take over, and he moved away from the place. The righteous are delivered before the days of evil. When God is on your side, you will be delivered before the day of evil. I am saying to somebody here today, any evil that is determined anywhere will happen after you must have left. God, we exonerate you from all evil and from all trouble. In the mighty name of Jesus. If you believe it, let your amen be better. How much do you want to say? The people are paying. They will say they put premium over pastor. When you can kill one pastor, this is how much you get. And we live on the same street with Boko Haram. We never know them, but they know us. They know pastor. They know you. You don't know them. They don't have identity, but they know you. Until the day soldiers came and carried them in our street, that before we discovered that, you mean we live this close with these people? And what happened? God. When God is by the side of a man, the enemy will see you and they will say, leave this one alone. Leave this one alone. They see a mark over you, it is a mark of honor. And they say, leave this one alone. Let this one go his own way. As the Lord live and as his spirit live, the mighty hands of God, the power of the Most High, will mark you out for honor. I said, the hand of God will mark you out for honor. In the mighty name of Jesus. The security that is sure, day and night, God will grant unto you in the mighty name of Jesus. In the midst of all trouble and dangers, God will protect you. God will defend you. God will preserve you. In the mighty name of Jesus. If you believe it, let your amen be better. When anyone wants to fight you, God has a way of rising on your behalf and fight the battle. When you are in the covenant of victory, you will never have occasion to run for the enemy. They will be the one who will be running away from you. Because God will put your fear upon them and your dread upon them. He said to Joshua in chapter 1 in verse 5 of the book of Joshua, he said there will not be a man that will be able to stand before you all the days of your life. No man will be strong enough to waylay you, to corner you, or to conquer you all the days of your life. You become unbeatable. I am believing God with you that you are unbeatable. Amen. And unbeatable you will be. Amen. In the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. By God's grace and by God's power, the keeper of Israel, the fighter, the one who fight the battle for his own, will fight all the battles for you in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. How much? How many do we want to count? Is it the one that will have happened before we get there, or the one who happened after we must have gone? When those bad boys want to waylay the road, they will just rush inside the middle of the road once during one of the rush hour, and they will attack many people. Most of the time, maybe we were a few minutes before then, that is when they will have done and get out of the way, and we will pass. And when we pass, people will be asking, did you see? We didn't see them, but we saw some things scattered by the road. Said, maybe they have gone. Or peradventure, we must have passed. Immediately after we pass, that is when they begin their operation. But what am I saying? When the covenant of God is over your life, it keeps you safe in the midst of all evil, in the midst of all danger. I am saying to somebody, in the midst of all danger, God will keep you safe. God will keep you secure. God will keep you protected. God will keep you defended. In the mighty name of Jesus, all those witches and wizards, all those familiar spirits, all those ogbanje mamiwata agent that are looking for trouble, you know, trouble, where to trouble people, the Lord will give them trouble. Amen. Anyone who look in your direction will be blindfolded. Amen. The hand of the Lord will silence them totally and completely. In the mighty name of Jesus, may the Lord keep you in dominion, and may the Lord keep you defended, protected, and defended every day of your life. In the mighty name of Jesus, the hand and the power of the Most High, God will cause it to rest upon you. In the mighty name of Jesus, a number of people were not killed by robbers, they were not killed by Boko Haram, they were killed by soldiers, and will walk in the same streets. And one day, one of them looked at me and said, I will fire you. Carry gun, cocking gun. Say, I will fire you. And what was our problem? The rule is, two people must not be in the car at the time. So I was driving, my wife was sitting by my side. So when we get to check, when somebody must come down. So I thought, it's better I come down, let her drive. So that you take the car, and I will take all the risk. And when you get to that point where they do, it is I surrender all. Your two hands must be up. I surrender all. And while I was moving in front, I discovered that the car was not. What happened to the car? Either out of anxiety or whatever, the car stopped. So, come now, the soldier said, keep moving, keep moving, keep moving. I said, my wife is there. I said, your wife is safe. Where she is, you are not safe. Say, let me go. He said, if you move back, I shoot you. And the man come the gun. Brah! So you take the next step, I fire you. Say, my wife, he said, I say, keep moving. A number of people were killed by soldiers, not by Boko Haram. In the midst of, say, I suspect you, the fire. Brew. But God keep, you know, in all those trouble, in all whatever, we move. And God defend and protected us. Somebody will come and say, how did you people survive? And I say, I don't know. God. God is the one, in the midst of all the things, in the midst of all the storm, in the midst of all the trouble, God was there to make sure that he keep us in one beat. But I remember, I used to tell people there, each time people were talking about death, I used to give them one Yoruba proverb. I said, I learned that from my father. The one who will tell the story of the battle will not die in the battlefield. So that he will be preserved to tell others this was how the battle went. I am going to tell the story what happened after this battle. So there is no way I will die. You will live to declare the glory of God. Amen. You will live to declare the counsel of God. Amen. When the battle is over, you will wear the crown. Amen. In the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. I speak to your life today. Everything that is threatening the life of others, that is putting fear into the life of others, will spare you. I say it will spare you. In the mighty name of Jesus. Because the mark of the Most High is over your life today. You will not be part of those who will go down in recession. You will not be one of those who will go down in by the attack of the enemy. You will not be a casualty of satanic attack. You will not be one of those that will be swallowed by demon. But the power of the Lord and the glory of the Lord will be your portion and carry you all the days of your life. In the mighty name of Jesus. You belong to the Lord. The Lord will watch over you. The Lord will keep you. The Lord will sustain you. The Lord will manifest his power over your life. In the mighty name of Jesus. Everywhere you go, the angel of safety, they will watch over you. They will pilot, they will escort you. In the mighty name of Jesus. The sun will not smite you by day. The moon will not smite you by night. In the mighty name of Jesus. The wind will not blow contrary to your life. In the mighty name of Jesus. The peace of God will rule over your life. In the mighty name of Jesus. Everything that it takes for you to survive and survive without a scare, the Lord grant unto you in the mighty name of Jesus. May the Lord perfect your testimony. May the Lord grant you the fulfillment of your good desires. May the Lord put you above and on top of all the storms of the enemy. May you ride over the storm and may you walk successfully to the other side. In the mighty name of Jesus. Where it is necessary, the Lord will calm the storm for you. Where the Lord needed to make you calm, the Lord will calm you and see you through. And give you perfect testimony to the glory and to the praise of his name. In the mighty name of Jesus. If you believe it, let your amen be better. Amen. I want you to say to the Lord this morning, say, Father, in every battles of life, be my companion. Be my ally. Fight all my battles for me and give me total victory. Go ahead, pray in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, fight all my battles for me and give me all total victory.